this morning from Ora Banda Mining's David Quinlivan. David, good morning. Good to have you back.
Good morning and great to be back again.
Been a little while, David, since we last spoke. So give us a bit of a refresh, what you've been up to at the Davyhurst project. How are things coming along?
Yeah, sure. I think last time we spoke, we were in the process of raising capital to actually restart the operations. So since then, we've completed a $55 million equity capital raise and are now fully funded to get back into production. So the last stage of that was wrapped up in September. Since then, we've engaged prime contractors for the refurbishment and remedial works program at the processing plant. We've engaged earth moving contractors to start on the open pit mining side of things, completed some camp upgrade works and other infrastructure upgrade works. And our mining teams are now mobilising to site with a view to recommencing commissioning and production in January of 2021.
Well, tell us more about what these production plans are.
Yeah, look, we're looking at starting off at two areas. Firstly, the Riverina open pit and the Golden Eagle underground operation. You might recall that we had five different open pits in the feasibility study that was published back in June. So we're starting off at Riverina and at Golden Eagle underground. And that will give us around 100,000 tonnes a month of ore that we need to keep the process plant running at full rated capacity of 1.2 million tonnes a year. Then after the Riverina operation, there's a sequenced mining program for all of the other five open pits that we have. We also recently announced to the market a maiden resource for the Riverina South extension and a small project that's about a kilometre away from the Riverina main mining pit area called British Lion. We did a 10,000 metre drill program there and came up with a maiden inferred resource, and we're working on planning now to bring that up to an indicated category so that that can then be incorporated into the Riverina open pit mine plan. Once we do that, that should extend the life of Riverina out a bit, and we'll see where that fits into the overall schedule. But Riverina and Golden Eagle for a kickoff.
So what needs to happen between now and getting into production? David, just give us a little reminder.
We're building stocks at Riverina at the moment. So one of the key things that we need to do is make sure that we've always got around 100,000 tonnes of ore ahead of the process plant so that we have continuity of feed going into it. So over the course of this next 3 months, November, December and January, we'll be building stocks of ore for a commencement of processing in end of January, February. And from then on, it's steady state mining for us and optimization of the project schedule.
And open pit initially.
It's majority open pit. Golden Eagle is a small underground operation. If you might recall from days gone by that it was an operation that was running when the company previously was put into administration and they developed a number of levels down there. So we're looking to go back into that underground mine and mine out those levels that were developed, because in essence, it gave us a bit of a free kick in terms of some relatively high grade production. So looking at a grade out of Golden Eagle underground of around 4 grams to blend with the open pit feed of around 2 grams.
So as you're getting back into production here, what are your expectations around production costs?
We had in our DFS an all-in sustaining cost of around $1,560 Australian an ounce. And we've got the optimization crew out there looking at how they can get a better cost outcome for us at the moment. So the feasibility study was done at, as you know, a $2,100 Australian gold price. The price has moved a little bit since then to currently sitting at around $2,650 or thereabouts today. So in Australian dollar terms, so a little bit more margin. And when you re-optimize at higher gold price, it naturally drops the cutoff grade that you get. So we're looking at how we can best optimise all our resources at the moment from a production point of view.
Well, indeed, certainly a good time to be coming into production, given the gold price.
A very good time. It's certainly been kind to us.
Are you continuing with the exploration program? Are you still drilling?
We are still drilling. We're just about to turn back on our regional program. The first few months of this financial year have been very much dedicated towards getting back on the production front. But we've now well advanced down that program, and we're starting to go back out and look at some of the higher prospectivity regional targets that we have. So yes, expect to see the exploration front ramp up between now and the end of this financial year.
And given how close you are to production, what's interest been like in Ora Banda?
Look, it's been quite a lot of interest. I mean, we relisted on ASX at around 15 cents, so we're now sitting just above 30. So given gold price, we've done reasonably well compared to the starting point that we came back on.
So what do you reckon, what's your main message here to your investors watching this morning here, David, given where you are and what you've got coming up around the corner?
Look, I think it's a case of Ora Banda now has a reasonably good plan that it's delivering against. We set out to come up with a definitive plan for a five-year mine life when we started. We did that with the DFS. We're now moving on the next phase, which is to bring us back into production. So money will stop going out the door and some of it will start coming back in. And that will allow us then to accelerate our exploration, regional exploration and resource definition programs. So on that front, we're looking to replace everything that we mine over the course of a year and then build on our resource and reserve base as we go forward.
And just a quick final word before I let you go then, as far as what we can expect in the coming weeks, as far as news, what are you working on?
Well, the quarterly report will be out tomorrow, so that will be a snapshot of the last quarter through until 30 December with some highlights of early October work. And our program at the moment is, as I said, concentrating on getting back into production, building ore stocks and targeting recommissioning of the processing plant in January. And at the same time, we'll be increasing our exploration effort over the course of the next 2 to 3 months.
Very good. Appreciate the catch up, David. Thanks for your time.
No worries. Thanks very much, and good to talk to you again.